currently driving through about 6 inches of slush, and it is the burb redemption mission.
Yep.
So yeah, we heard the spawn is on, and it's time to grease some burbs.
So he just said there's a ball down there. And basically what that means, it's a spawn ball. A female will kind of be getting right, and a bunch of males will kind of just surround her, shoot their stuff everywhere, and that's how love is made.
There we go.
Scooped it right off bottom. I wasn't even really watching.
Oh,
it's a walleye. Out of season. I feel like that's kind of how burb fishing got more popular, is guys were walleye fishing and they'd run into burbs. And then boom.
Dude, look at that thing.
Back you go.
That is a dark, beautiful burb.
See you, buddy. Get back down there. Summer in the middle of the day, dude.
It's 1 o'clock in the afternoon. It's probably 55 degrees out. It's legit hot.
Unreal.
And we're stroking.
I am going to try to grab it more and film you, though. It's just nice. It's like even just watching your videos. It's nice to see like a big camera angle.
Yeah.
Every now and then. Which you got some good footage of Brett talking about his. That's actually helps a lot too.
Oh, I might have got bumped.
There we go. Bump me. That a babe. He gave it just a little taste. Ooh. Oh, okay. Okay. I think it's a big fish, dude. Yeah, I do actually think it's a big fish.
You look good with a rod loaded up.
Elliot Siskoet just thunk. This is a big lake trout rod, but it doubles for an awesome burb rod.
Oh, he choked.
He's another fatty.
That's a fat one.
Yes. Love.
Yeah. Burbs. Look at the tummy. That one pulled. That one pulled, pulled, pulled. He choked it. I don't know what the camera angle is like, but he like bumped it once and then whoop, bam, ball go.
Burb it!
Love is definitely in the air. And it's not just with the burbs, it's with me. I love you. Let's get on the boy back. Get down there. Give me some of that.
You think it's all right?
No, that's okay. So I thought he was stuck on the bottom of the ice, but I think he's just heavy. I can probably get to him.
Pin can grab him, pin can grab him, dude.
All right. Yeah, it's definitely heavy. I thought he was already to the bottom of the ice and it was just dead weight though. He should be within about 5 feet here.
Coming up.
Yeah, it's okay.
Oh, it is a good one.
It's a good one, dude.
Oh, God. He's like wedged.
He is wedged there.
Got a babe.
Nice.
Got a babe, dude.
Thanks, man. Gorgeous. This one's already spawned out.
Beautiful fish, dude.
See the C-section mark?
Yeah.
Yeah. I love it, man. I love it.
Tell me about what you're using. You're using some, or should we not? Do we not?
We could probably show this.
Okay.
I got to give credit where credit's due, though. My buddy Tim Hansky got some big old pout pounders and customized them. Synthetic hairs, they really hold scent well. Double rattle chamber, extra glow paint.
Dang.
They love
it. Did you have minnows on the back of that?
Yeah, so I actually just,
I'll show you a little trick.
When I walleye fish all summer, you have extra shiners. I just throw them in plastic bags and freeze them flat. So then I've got shiners when people stop selling shiners all year long. And they're just stinky and burbot love them. And there's probably nobody else with shiners right now.
And would you say burbot are basically running either off their lateral line or their scent because they don't have great eyes, right? That's what we
think?
Yeah,
it's kind of a myth, I would honestly say. It's common knowledge, supposedly, that they don't have good eyesight. But if you drop an underwater camera down there, the camera can be 10 feet under the ice, and I've watched burbot swim from 30 feet deep straight up and hit that camera.
Really?
So I don't know if they're feeling that or seeing that, but they're pretty aware of what's going on.
Oh, this is so sick.
Oh!
Please tell me. End record right now.
Nice job.
Thanks for the assist, brother. Yes. That one's pretty.
That is a beautiful bird. That's beautiful. Oh, nice leopard spots.
Yeah. Little tattoo there.
You caught some of them you caught earlier this year had some wicked marks on them.
Yeah, big black blotches, and some of them will get yellow blotches.
I just want to slap them.
It's kind of cool that you can almost tell what lake they come from or area based on the patterns.
From somebody who's been fishing burbs quite a few years to somebody who's been fishing burbs for like 3 years, give some suggestions or some pointers to some folks if they want to get into it. Say they've never done it before, they know a lake that potentially might have them. What would you tell that person?
I would say, depends on kind of the time of the year. If it's late February, look for walleye spots. Look for stuff that on the map you're like, this looks like a walleye spot, or places where all the permanent houses were and then they were taken off the lake because the deadline. It's just, they're feeding on the same stuff. Little perch and stuff on the edge of the weed flats. And later in the year, like as we get to now into March, the first week of March, mid-March, that's where it's more like sandy steep breaks. They love to spawn in those steep sandy breaks, and 20 to 30 feet of water, you really can't go wrong. And it's like any fish where you should be moving if you're not seeing fish. If you're fishing for 15, 20 minutes and you haven't grabbed a fish, move. Even if it's just 200 yards down the break, drill a hole. And the hard thing with burbot is you can't really do that until you're in that daytime prime bite. Earlier in the season, you're picking a good spot and you're sitting there and you're hoping you get 1, 2, 3 fish to come through. But when you're in that March 7th all the way through until you can't get on the ice anymore, they're active, they're schooling up, there's tons of fish. If you find one fish, there's a bunch more near it, right? They're not solos. So keep moving and moving until you're graphing fish. And if you're graphing fish, stay put, because it's just a matter of time before they bite.
Tonight, oh, down beside that red fat line, oh, you gonna let it all hang out, fat bottom girls, you make the rockin' world go round.
No trouble.
Are we
going around
with
you still?
Yeah.
Park out here.
Minnows check, auger check, brother Cole check. I think right off the gate, we're just gonna kinda go to the same holes that we checked yesterday, drop the camera down. Our buddies are coming in just a little bit, the fellas that kinda brought us out to this area. So we'll get fishing. And yesterday Peyton was doing a lot of camera work. So basically he'd run this whole break line with that camera, and when he saw him balled up, he would holler, we'd run over fish those holes. So here's some of our holes from yesterday. It's nice with a big old wrecking ball jig or a big old spoon, you really don't need to have a clean hole. So if we just pop these open, drop the camera down, see something purdy, we'll be good to go.
Oh, two of them rubbing on each other, right by me. Eat. Oh, two of them. Oh, gonna eat right here. Eat it. Just. I just don't want to get caught on this camera. No, you're good. Two of them swam through, watched him on the camera. Oh, there he is.
Oh, it's a nice one, dude. It's a fatty.
Let's go.
I should have grabbed my line.
Look at that thing.
It's a fatty.
Dude, that's a short, fat one.
It's a fat, clumpy one.
Look at this thing.
All right, we got the camera down in the hole I was in. And I watched two of them swim in, just rubbing side by side. They left the camera view, came back in, and they were just watching my jig. I was thumping it on the bottom.
Show me how fat that one is, dude.
Nose down.
That is a plumpy fat one. Dude, yes!
First one in the morning. It's not even 11 o'clock yet. I think the bite window might be starting up. This could get good. We've been seeing a bunch of them, and none of them have shown any interest at all. And this one came in and definitely, I would say he was interested in eating.
That is a great way to break the ice.
That's a good one. Nice, dude. Look at the belly on that thing.
Dude, literally the greenback just bent over.
Wow.
Oh my gosh, let's get some dope pictures.
Such a cool fish. She's a thick girl.
Dude, I got a good hook set on that one.
Hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah. These northern Minnesota lakes, that's the coolest part, is it seems like these fish, not only do they have beautiful colors, they're just grotesquely fat. At least the females are, like right now before they spawn. So that was freaking awesome. On the board. We're on the board.
Oh, there's a ball. There's a ball.
Really?
Yep.
Grab your rod.
Which way are they? Hold on. They're starting to disperse. Like right here.
You think they're that close?
Yeah. So straight from the hole this way. There's like 10 now. Oh my God, you're right in the middle. You're in the middle. Just pound the very bottom. Dude, you're in the middle of the ball. Oh, okay, oh, I should be recording.
Hit record.
Yep. Oh my gosh. How are you not getting bit?
Can you see my jig?
Dude, there's a wild leopard print one.
Should I do little pounds on the bottom?
Yes. Dude, you're in the ball. What is going on?
Recording?
Yeah. They just probably have no interest in eating right now. No, they're all right there.
There we go.
Oh, you sn- Yeah.
Oh,
he's snagged. I bet he's snagged.
He feels heavy though. Probably because he's...
He might be foul hooked.
Probably.
Yeah.
Come on, get your head up here. Oh.
How's it feel?
It feels pretty good, dude. It feels pretty heavy. It feels really heavy. Here he goes, here he comes. Oh.
Yeah, baby!
What just happened?
That was freaking awesome. This is a beautiful dark one right here. We're not gonna talk long. I'm gonna get them right back down there because they are freaking down there. I want Pint to get down there with his spoon. Beautiful.
Nice.
Kind of a beauty save too.
Yeah, you went deep in there.
Let's get this beautiful pout back. See you, buddy. Our buddies are waiting for us at the axis. I'm gonna go pick them up. Pin's gonna stay here. Bam.
On.
On.
Yep. Sam just is heading out to go get those other boys. We just found a spawn ball of them and they are eating right now. Sam literally got his up released. He grabbed my rod. I dropped down before he left and I'm already on. He's coming back. I think he's at the bottom of the ice. Yep. This might be a good one.
Oh yeah.
Nice one. Oh, look at how white it is.
Dude.
The pattern on that
thing. Freaking beautiful.
Is that old?
Oh.
Oh my God.
Dude, it's beautiful.
Is that just like an insanely old bird? Oh my gosh, dude. Look at that.
That's beautiful. He's just got wicked cool colors.
Look at the spots on his...
Hold him up. Yeah, get him unhooked and hold him up.
Oh my God.
Man, I gotta go get the boys.
So the ones we've been catching have been like dark. But this thing is like a light color and he's just got dark blotches all over him. Look at that. Look how cool that fin
dude,
is.
Mad character, dude.
And if you... I don't know if you guys can see the eyes on it, but it looks like it's like almost blind in both eyes.
Dude,
wow. And so when Sam was fishing and I was working the camera, I saw this fish down there because you could tell it was a lot lighter and it had these dark spots all over them. And then I caught it 5 minutes later.
You saw that, dude.
What is going on?
Let's get a quick picture that they're down there. They're balled up. Yep. They're spawning.
And they're not leaving. They're in the same hole.
Truck's packed, we said goodbye to the boys, and I feel lucky that we even got the opportunity to drive the truck out there. Like the whole ride back, it was starting to get really slushy, starting to be a lot of water, still plenty of safe ice. It's just like getting on and off the lakes and the axes, it's getting pretty rough. So I'm pumped we came up when we did. We hit it during the spawn. The amount of fish we caught wasn't crazy. We didn't catch hundreds and hundreds of burbot. We caught a decent amount, still got redemption, but what we got to see on the underwater camera this week was incredible. We saw them spawning, we saw spawn balls, saw a lot of cruisers. Just the amount of fish we saw on those steep breaks, it was awesome. So once again, I cannot thank Peyton and all his buddies enough for kind of taking us out, showing us right where to go, their program. We're not burbot fishermen. We've only been doing this a couple years and there's not burbot around our area. So just to be able to come up here, learn from Peyton and his pals and get the experience and really set the hook a few times, it was awesome. So thank you guys. Really quick, we'll talk to Cole and we'll walk through our setups because I don't even know if we talked about it much.
No, we didn't really. So I was just kind of talking with Brett before we went and I had a jig on like Sam did. And he said just to try to change it up with a spoon of some sort. And normally I would go with like a green glow spoon, but I went with just like a flashy like orange and yellow buckshot. And it, I mean, it's the same weight as basically like the pulp candy spoons with like a little bit lighter treble on it, but it didn't really seem like they cared. I mean, they were eating all the same thing. 10-pound braid, Elliott greenback, did the trick.
That's seriously the best when you can hook set like your dang bass fishing, you're on the ice. We had awesome weather, it was 50 degrees. My setup, a lot like Cole's, Elliott rods, except this one's a Siskoet, a little bit heavier rod. This is, I think, mainly made for lake trout fishing, but it duels well for any predator, big game fish, and obviously burbot. So we'll link all that stuff down below. And like I said, we'll link all the boys' stuff. Thank you. Thank you for watching a little late ice quick adventure. And yeah, I guess there's nothing left to be said. Stay tuned. And as always, look adventure. Oh, my pretty babe, something ain't right. Got to find a way to move ahead. Oh, my pretty babe.